To introduce myself, my name is Nabil Farag. I'm professor of cardiology at Shams University. I would like to speak about the anti-thrombotic therapy in patients with ischemic heart disease and atrial fibrillation, whether this ischemic heart disease is a chronic coronary syndrome or an acute coronary syndrome, because this is very hot subject, and we have a lot of opinions about this, whether to use a triple therapy. Triple therapy means dual antiplatelet therapy like aspirin and P2Y12 inhibitor in addition to anticoagulants, and which anticoagulants? The vitamin K antagonists, warfarin, or the NUX or non-vitamin K antagonists. And which dose of this as regard if we are going to use a triple therapy. First, we have a lot of clinical trials. Some of them used the dual therapy. Dual therapy means P2Y12 inhibitors plus oral anticoagulants from the start. And some trials using this dual therapy after 1 month, after giving triple therapy for 1 month, then dual therapy, and some trials using triple therapy for 3 months, then dropped aspirin after 3 months using dual therapy, oral anticoagulants plus LP2Y12 inhibitors. Myself, I prefer to use this triple therapy for 1 month and then drop aspirin after that. And when we use a triple therapy, if we are going to use warfarin or vitamin K antagonist, in this condition, keep INR between 2 and 2.5, not between 2 and 3 like others. If we are going to use the NUX or the new oral anticoagulants, in this condition, use the low dose of NUX if we are going to use the triple therapy. So if you are going to use apixaban in addition to aspirin and B2Y12 inhibitor, you can use apixaban 2.5 twice. If you are going to use rivaroxaban, you can use rivaroxaban 15 milligram once daily in addition to the dual antiplatelet therapy. And if you are going to use dabigatran 110 twice daily with the triple therapy. And the B2Y12 inhibitor of choice in this condition should be clopidogrel, not other new B2Y12 inhibitors, either ticagrelor or prasugrel. And after 1 month, you can drop aspirin and you can keep on both P2Y12 inhibitors, and the drug of choice is clopidogrel, as I said before, and the oral anticoagulants, which either the warfarin, keeping an INR between 2 and 2.5, or the NUX. In this condition, we can increase the dose of NUX to the traditional dose. After dropping aspirin after 1 month, you can use the B2Y12 inhibitor clopidogrel, not the new P2Y12 inhibitors like ticagrelor or prasugrel. The standard of care is clopidogrel. And in this condition, you can use NUX with a traditional dose, apixaban 5 mg twice daily, rivaroxaban 20 mg once daily, and dabigatran you can use 150 twice daily. And if you are going to use warfarin, keep again the INR between 2 and 2.5. This is my main messages about patients with atrial fibrillation requiring oral anticoagulants who have ischemic heart disease as well, either chronic coronary artery disease undergoing PCI or acute coronary syndrome, whether kept on medical treatment or undergoing PCI. And thank you.